Hello folks, in this one I'm just coding a couple of features into my BMW 420i. There's an app called, I call it BimmerCode because it's spelled B-I-M-M-E-R-C-O-D-E. Lots of other YouTubers refer to it as BimmerCode. I'm going to be using that today and I'm just going to basically walk you through what I do and what I'm looking to achieve with it. For me, there are all sorts of things you can do with this app, but for me I just wanted to add a couple of very simple little functions that are frustrations with the car that you can't change in the stock menu. So, tiny little OBD2 scanner, which I'll show you and I'll link to, plug that into the car, hook it up to your phone with Bluetooth, use the app, job done. The good thing with the scanner as well, you can also use it for fault codes and things. So I'm just going to keep that in the car forever. If the car ever throws up a fault, I can diagnose it at the roadside, see if it's a, you know, catastrophic failure or something that's going to cause problems, or just carry on about my way. Hopefully I'll never have to use it. There we go. Keep watching. Here's the little device here. And that's what it looks like. We're just going to plug that into the OBD2 scanner like that. It connects to my phone via Bluetooth. Okay, so the OBD2 scanner is just down here, just by the bonnet release. It's got a nice little cover on it. And you just plug it in. Okay, so I'm gonna have the engine running for this just in case it flattens the battery or anything. So I think it does take a little bit of time. Okay, so now I'm going into the BimmerCode app. Okay, so it's now found the adapter clearly. It's asking me what kind of BMW I've got. I've got the 4 Series, it's the F32 2016. This is a 420i with xDrive. So BMW 4 Series, check in terminal status. Reading vehicle order, identifying control units. This bit can take a bit of time, so it's going through and reading all the individual control units. It's not like there's just one control unit. There are several within the car, so it's reading those. It's finding out what's in the car, what's already coded into the car, and then it'll give me the options sort of specific to this car, I guess. The main things I want to do is I want the speedo as digital on the digital display on the dash rather than just with the old-fashioned analog dial. I just prefer it that way. Not everyone does, each to their own. I was hoping I could code electric folding wing mirrors. When you lock the car, the wing mirrors automatically fold in, but this car hasn't got folding wing mirrors. You have to manually fold them, so I can't do that. That's a bit annoying. It's the thing with German cars sometimes, you know, things that you might expect to come in a fairly luxury car are optional extras. Right, okay, so here's my choice. These are all the standard things. You can go into expert mode and do all sorts of other funky stuff, but I don't really need to do any of that, and nor do I want to. So tailgate function, let's have a look at that. It's one of the things, when you close the boot with the key ring, you have to hold it down to close it, and I'd rather just do one press. And I wouldn't mind when I'm doing it with the remote if it beeped, and I think you can do those things on here. We'll have a look. As you can see, it's not a particularly rapid process because it's reading all the data from the ECU and then transmitting it to this via Bluetooth. Just amuse yourselves, guys, while this is happening, okay? So there we go. Tailgate function, remote control, open and close. Yep. Close tailgate with button in interior without long press. Okay. Close tailgate with a remote control without long press. Yes. Warning sound when closing the tailgate with remote control. Yes. Okay, so then we're going to press code and start coding. Now at this point, those choices I've made on the app, and this is just specific to that tailgate function module, because it's one module that controls that. It's now writing that code to that module. It also creates a backup. So if after I've done this, something goes wrong, anything goes wrong, I can just restore the backup and I'll go back to the point before I'd coded that in. So it's a bit of a fail safe, really. And all these standard functions, you can't really do any damage to your car. If you go into the expert mode and you start messing about with that, it's a fairly deep dive code. And if you do the wrong thing, you could get yourself in a bit of trouble. So, unless you're an expert with this or you've got expert advice, just stick to the main functions. There's also a similar one of these things called Carly that a lot of people promote, and they have affiliate deals and you get some money if you sign up. Carly's a great app as well and a good tool. It's a bit more expensive and it's an annual subscription, where with this, if you've got BMW obviously, BimmerCode, once you pay for it, you've got it forever. And you can use it on as many cars as you want. So if you've got two BMWs or your friend's got one, someone at work's got one, you can use it on any of them. Can't remember the price off the top of my head, but I'm sure it's about 30 quid or something like that. Okay, so that one's done. Now, what's the next one I wanted to do? The instrument cluster. So this is where I want to get that digital speedo readout on the instrument cluster there. So I'm not just got the needle to look out, I've actually got the exact speed. I'm a bit strange and I don't particularly like the BMW analog dials. They just have 20, 40, 60, 80. And I don't know, each to their own, but I'd like to have a digital readout. So I'm just going to try and code that in now. You can also change like the start logos and all sorts of stuff with this. None of it really appeals to me, but you can do all that. You can also change the levels that your low fuel warnings come in, which is quite a nice feature. Right, digital speed in board computer, yes. That's the only one I really want to do there, to be fair. Right, so we're going to code that one in, start coding. And again, it's writing the data now to the instrument cluster. It's now restarting the ECU, which it does when it's coded something. Date and time. So we've got 12/22, 17th of October, day, date, month, month, year. Yep. And we'll put it on automatic time setting. Great, okay, that's worked. Well, you've got stuff you can do with the air conditioning. I don't really want to do that. Seatbelt reminder, you can change the speed at which the seatbelt reminder clicks in. So you can switch it on or off if you want. I want it on because in case I do forget to put it on, but I probably don't want it to kick in so early. So it's currently set to kick in at 10 kmph. I'm going to set it to 20. I'm just going to code that one in. And then is there anything else I was going to do? Right, the other thing I'm going to do is, there's a really annoying feature with this where when you get out of the car, the stereo system stays on until you've locked the car, which just bugs the hell out of me. Like in most of my cars, when you open the door, that shuts off the stereo system. There's no way to make that happen through the head unit, so I'm going to do it here with a code, I hope. So let's go back into, we're in head unit. This is the MBT Evo, it's the iDrive 5, in case you're wondering. There's an absolute ton of stuff you can do with the front electric module. So just to give you a really quick overview, ambient lighting, angel eyes, you can change the brightness, the audio system shut off when driver doors open, which is the thing I want to do, so I'm gonna do that one. You can turn off the start stop by default. You've got all this convenient closing stuff, so if you've got like a sunroof, or you can get it to always close your windows when you lock the car, if you turn on convenient closing, daytime running light brightness. If you want to change the car over to LED lights, you can go in here and change that and sort of code it in. Otherwise you might have problems if you add LED lights without coding it in. Have it so your fog lights always come on with high beam, fog lights with parking lights, hazard warning signal after emergency braking, mess about with your cornering lights, mirrors fold automatically. Again, if you've got electric folding mirrors in your car, you can have them to automatically fold in when you lock the car, fold back out when you unlock it. Retrofit steering wheel with paddles, I've already got that. You can mess about with the seat heating temperatures. So if you find it's a bit too warm on your tush, you can turn it down. Welcome lights, there's an absolute ton of stuff you can do with that. Even wipe cycles after front washing. So when you wash the windscreen, how many times it does the wiper blades automatically. So all that kind of good stuff. So all I've coded there is the thing to shut off the iDrive when you open the door. And that's it, I'm not actually gonna code anything else. I'll just quickly whip through the other options, but I don't think I'm going to code anything else into the car. Just restarting the ECU again. Coding successful. So the other options we've got here, the seatbelt reminder stuff there's a lot of stuff you can do with the air conditioning, which I won't go into. Transmission control. So if you don't have a sport transmission, I do. If you don't have a sport transmission, you can code that in. All that front electric module stuff that I just went through, the head unit stuff we've had a look at, instrument cluster we've had a look at, integrated chassis management, active cruise control, driving mode, some stuff around that. I'm not going to mess about with that. The parking sensors and rear view camera, you can code those in, like if you retrofit a rear view camera or something, or parking sensors. Roof function center, acoustic confirmation alarm system, not going to mess about with that, don't know what it is, and tailgate function. So that's it. And then you can, of course, also go into the expert mode and you can do all sorts of stuff. So this car's got enhanced Bluetooth, which means you can send Bluetooth audio to the car rather than just phone calls. And it can see album art for music you're streaming and all that sort of stuff. If it doesn't come as standard, you can actually code that in on a lot of these cars, but you have to go through the advanced menu and there's quite a lot of steps to go through and you really need expert advice on that. And I would not recommend you have a go yourself with that at all. But that's just a really quick overview of what you can do with this app and with one of these little dongles. These things are great as well because obviously you can go and use this as to clear codes and stuff and read fault codes. I mean, if you get a fault code pop up on your car and you don't know what it is, it could cost you a fair amount of money just to get the fault diagnosed, where you can at least then in future call a garage and say, I've got this code, it means this, and they can, you know, you're not paying for the diagnostic on it, are you? You're just paying for a repair or some parts. So I think they're great little things and I'm just going to keep mine in the car. You never know when you're going to get a fault code. It might be something non-serious, but it might put the car into limp or something like that. And it's great if you can just clear it yourself and get on with your journey, really, isn't it? So once again, I'll put a link to that in the video description and I'll pin a link to it as well as the first comment in the video. So have a look at that below. And if you use that link, Amazon will throw me, I don't know, probably 20 pence or something, but please use the link, it helps support the channel. Okay, so I've just taken the car for a quick run around the block and the seatbelt thing's working perfectly. Just tested the boot, that's working as it should, and also you can see just in there I've got the digital speedo, which was the main thing I wanted. As I said before, not important to everyone, is important to me, so therefore I've now got it. Brilliant. Hope you enjoyed that one, guys. Bit of a different one from me. And let me know in the comments. Be nice. Be nice in the comments. And remember, my choice of car might not be yours, but I don't care. YouTube suggesting you might like to watch this video next, so go and click on that because I'm sure they're right, aren't they? YouTube's always right. Go and watch that video. Thanks.